When I teach grammar, I first explain the rules and I will have take-home or in-class practices of these grammatical rules. The most important thing is that students can use the grammar correctly and appropriately. So I design activities that require them to create sentences that are grammatically and pragmatically correct. In this section, you will see the grammar activities we did in class.
Do you know what does it mean? 有利息的储蓄账户. What is 储蓄账户? Saving account. Yes, a saving account with interest. With interest. So in English with, in Chinese we usually translate as 有 something. So 有利息的储蓄账户. So 有 is a verb. An account that has interest. 有利息的储蓄账户. Or 表, what kind of 表? Like what is the purpose of this 表 form? 申请学校的表. This form is for applying for a school. 申请学校的表. Or place, 地方, what kind of place it is? 吃午饭, 吃 is eat, so that's the verb, and the object is 午饭, the place for you to eat lunch, 吃午饭的地方. So that's how we modify a noun in Chinese, like we use sort of like in other sentences to modify the noun. Hey, could you give me some examples like by following this rule? Okay. What is then? What about the verb? You have to start this phrase with the verb. 吴晨星.
学中文的学校.
学中文的学校. 学中文的学校, Chinese school. These are the examples from your practices. So the structure verb plus object plus the and plus and is noun phrase. So everything before the noun is used to modify the noun, like to describe the purpose of this noun, this object, or its features, particular things about this noun. So for example, if you look at number one, 打篮球的鞋子. So the head noun, the point is, this is a pair of shoes, and this pair of shoes is for playing basketball. So 打篮球的鞋子, or you can look at number two, 吃小笼包的店. That is a store that you, or a place that you can have 小笼包. So 吃小笼包, here's the verb, object, and the. So to describe what kind of a restaurant it is that you can, so it's a restaurant that you can have.
And some more parts, so have, I have verbs like 有, and object, like 晚饭. And now, for example, 房间. So, and I'll distribute the cards now. And please find people that you think you can match. Mm-hmm. Okay. Here's it, if you're finished.
Sure, one family.
Do you know what this means? Yeah,
a dining table or eating
table. Okay, what about your sentence?
It's a poor. Poor? Poor, like don't have any money?
穷.
穷. So, 我太穷,我没有吃晚饭的桌子.
很好. I'm too poor, so I don't have the table. Remember the first meaning is completion of action. So 第一个句子怎么说?
我吃饭了。
You can also say 我吃了饭 or 我吃了饭了. So how would you translate this sentence into English? 我吃饭了。I ate. 是的,我吃饭了. Or if you want to insert a major word, you can say 我吃了一碗饭.
I ate a bowl of rice. So, the question is, how would you say, did you eat in Chinese? 你吃了饭吗? 很好. And, 蔡锦, 你吃了午饭了吗?
我没吃。没有吃。没有吃。好。康麦,
你写了中文作业了吗? 还没,很好. So, be careful that the is not a past tense marker. For example, if you finish the action that you went to your friend's place and finish the action of eating, you can say 昨天, yesterday, 昨天我去朋友家吃了饭, or just 吃饭. So, the just indicates the action is complete. That indicates that this event happened in the past, now, or future. So, that's something you should remember. So, think about how would you say, I have studied Chinese for more than a year. More than a
一年多了,
好, you should remember. So, think about how would you say, I have studied Chinese for more than a year.
我什么?
More than a 一年多了, 好。 周文杰, 你今天去过Hub吗?
今天我没去过Hub。
那你今天吃过午饭了吗?
我吃过午饭。吃过饭了,
so what does 过 indicate? Do you remember 过?
That you've already done it?
Things you already done or you have experienced something. For example, Wu Chenxing, 你去过上海吗?
我去过上海。
So, he has been to Shanghai before. So that's one of his experiences. 你吃过小笼包吗?
我吃过小笼包。小笼包好吃吗?
很好吃。 很好吃,好. Now please use 过 to make the sentence, to make the question and ask your classmate. Think about to use for. 佳音,你的问题是什么? What's your question?
你去过加拿大吗?
你去过加拿大吗? 菲可丽, 你去过加拿大吗?
我去过加拿大。
你怎么去的? 你怎么去的? 好, what did you get? 开车去加拿大有多久? 有多久? How long?
我不知道。
Can't remember.
Yeah.
忘了。好, 贝可丽你的问题, what's your question?
你去过纽约吗?
你去过纽约吗? 林中信, 你去过纽约吗?
是,我去过纽约。纽约好,
你的问题是什么?
你今天看过电影吗?
李启贤, 你今天看过电影吗?
我今天没有看过电影。
好, 李启贤, 你的问题呢?
你吃过韩国菜吗?
你吃过韩国菜吗? 陆毅?
我吃过韩国菜。
韩国菜在哪儿吃的?
会说, Zion Street?
什么?